Hello viewers, today we discuss the basic concepts of estimation. The estimation is a statistical tool. We use this tool in econometric methods. In everyday life, we use approximate values in place of actual values. The actual values involves high cost and time. The approximate figures are relatively easy to obtain when compared to the exact figures. For example, if someone is interested in knowing the average lodging charges in Hyderabad, then he has to collect information from all lodges located in Hyderabad. This is a time consuming, tedious and costly affair. Even one takes all the trouble, there is no guarantee that the figure obtained does not contain any error. Therefore, in many cases, approximate figures are used in place of actual figures. These approximate figures are called estimates of the actual figures. In statistical language, the actual figures are called parameters of the population, which are generally unknown, and approximate figures are called the sample statistic. Sample statistic is considered as estimate of population parameter. Here we are discussing approximate values and actual values. To find actual values, it is very costly affair, time taking affair. Therefore, instead of actual values, we take the approximate values. Just now I told you about somebody wants to know the average lodging charges in Hyderabad. For that, the person has to move different areas. He has to collect the information from each and every lodge located in Hyderabad. So, how much time he has to take? So, how much cost is involved in this? So, it is very difficult, painstaking. Therefore, instead of collecting each and every unit, we collect the sample items. Here I have taken the example of all lodges located in Hyderabad. So, instead of going all lodges, he has to pick up some units or some lodges in Hyderabad. So, based on the few units, because he has to study some 50 lodges located in Hyderabad, and based on that information, he can estimate the actual values with the help of few items. Okay, no doubt here somebody wants to question, sir, we are taking only few lodges here and we are ignoring the all lodges. If you collect the data with only few lodges, can we get the true value? Yes, of course. With econometric techniques, we can estimate actual values with the sample data. So, the figures, that is actual figures, if we collect the each and every item, based on that, if you get the value, also may not give accurate value, because it is a time taking, costly affair. Instead of going that, we are taking only sample items. So, with this also, we can predict the actual values. So the figures, that is actual figures, are called parameters of the population, which are generally unknown, because generally we cannot go in detail with the population studies. In statistics, population means we have to collect each and every item's information. It is very difficult to collect the information, therefore we have to take only sample figures. The sample figures will give approximate values. The approximate values, how it arrive, the exact value, that can be taken as the sample statistic. The sample statistic is considered as estimate of population parameter. Now, we will discuss some basic concepts, that is the statistical concepts often we use in econometric methodology. One is population. In statistical terminology, a population or universe is the totality of units under study, and a population character is an attribute of population unit. In statistics, we take population or universe. It doesn't mean that population means all the persons. Population in statistics means the total units under a study, or we can call it as universe. For example, we are interested in the salaries of workers in Indian Railways. So, the population is the totality of workers in Indian Railways. In Indian Railways, totally how many workers are working, that comes under population. All the workers we have to consider, that is called population. Then the characteristic of interest, that is each worker's salary. We are interested in finding out the salaries, average salaries, that is characteristic of interest. So, population may be finite or infinite. Finite population. A population that is not infinitely large, or that contains only a finite number of items. So, finite population means the whole items can be countable. It can be countable. For example, in a classroom, we take the total students, we can count them. And also, in a country, total population, we can count them. This is called finite population. That is limited, we can count them as a number. But infinite population, we cannot count them individually. That includes infinitely large number of individual units. For example, a forest is an example for infinite population. And also, a bag of rice is also an example for infinite population. In finite population, we can count the number, that is how many units are there, that can be countable. Whereas infinite population, the number cannot be countable. Then sample. A sample is any group of measurements selected from a population for analysis. As I said earlier, population means all the units covered under the study. Sample means instead of all the units, we pick up some units from the population. Say, for example, in Indian Railways, there may be some 50,000 workers. But in sample, we are not taking all the 50,000 workers. We may pick up out of 50,000 only 500 as a sample. This is called sample. That means a sample is any group of measurements selected from a population for analysis. So, this is called sample. Then, population parameter. Any characteristic of a population is called population parameter. Generally, it is unknown and it is denoted by Greek letter theta. For example, an average monthly salary of workers in Indian railways is the population parameter. The population parameters are estimated with the help of sample statistic. Here, if we want to find out the average monthly salary of workers in Indian railways, that means we have to go to the each and every worker of Indian railways and find out their salaries. After collecting the whole information, we have to take the average figure. So, that is very difficult task. So, therefore, generally it is unknown. So, the population parameter is unknown. So, to collect the actual value, instead of going to all 50,000 workers and collecting the information, and we take only sample figure, that is, we go to only 500 workers and collect the information, based on them we estimate a figure, that is, average monthly salary of that particular workers. Then, after finding this figure, we can estimate the whole 50,000 workers' salary. Therefore, the population parameters are estimated with the help of sample statistic. Then, sample statistic. Any characteristic of a sample is called sample statistic, and it is generally denoted by letter small t. For example, the average monthly salary of sample of workers in Indian railways with small t, that is a sample statistic. Here we are taking the sample figure 500, as I said, 500 is a sample figure. Total figure is 50,000, that 50,000 is population, 500 is sample. So, you want to calculate the average salary of 500 workers is small t. Then, you want to collect the average monthly salary of 50,000 workers is theta. To calculate theta is very difficult, but only with the help of sample statistic small t, we can estimate the true population parameter, that is theta. If small t value is, for example, 20,000 rupees, if you collect the entire 50,000 workers' salary also 20,000, then our t is estimated accurate value. So, based on sample, we can estimate the accurate value, that is, with the approximate value, we can estimate the actual values. Then next, estimator. The method of estimating population parameter is called an estimator. Just now I told you about the 20,000 is the average monthly salary. So, that is how you arrive that figure. How do you get that figure? Based on the method of estimation. The method of estimations are generally available, sample, mean or median. So, the estimator is here sample, mean or median. Based on the sample mean, we can estimate the actual value. So, that is estimator. Then estimate. The numerical value of the sample mean is called an estimate of the population mean. The 20,000 figure is estimate, that is, the numerical value of the sample mean is called an estimate of the population mean. Just now I spoke about 20,000 rupees monthly salary, that is an estimate. Estimator is sample mean or median. So, estimator is a method, estimate is a numerical value. Then point estimate. If a single value is provided as an estimate of unknown population parameter, then it is called point estimate. For instance, rupees 15,000 is the point estimate of average monthly salary of workers in Indian Railways. Here we are saying only one particular estimate, one value, single number, that is called point estimate. Then interval estimate. Instead of a single number, if a range is provided in which the parameter is likely to lie, then it is called interval estimate of the parameter. Along with the range, the degree of reliability is also provided. The range is referred to as confidence interval, and the degree of reliability is called confidence level. For instance, interval estimate of average monthly salary of workers in Indian Railways is rupees 14,000 to 16,000 with a reliability of 90%. In this case, confidence interval is 14,000 to 16,000 rupees and confidence level is 90%. So, it may be noted that the reliability of estimate can be increased by increasing the width of interval estimate. Here confidence interval, confidence level, we can take 90% or 95%, 99%, that is the confidence level. Whereas the figures, that is 14,000 to 16,000 with a reliability of 90% or 95%, 99%, we can consider. That means the estimated value explains 90% true. So, that way we can estimate the interval estimate. So, these are the some of the basic points we often use in econometric methods. Then after estimating the estimate, we have to see that the estimate really followed the desirable properties of estimators or not. If the estimate follows desirable properties, then only we will consider it as a best estimate. Therefore, to discuss desirable properties of estimators, there are some principles. They are: 1. Unbiasedness. An estimator is said to be an unbiased estimator of theta if the expected value of t is equal to the true theta, that is et is equal to theta. What is the theta? Theta is here true population parameter. As I said earlier, that is if we collect the entire values or entire items, based on that if we get the value, that is theta. That is, in other words, we can say that actual value or true value. Then et, that means estimated or expected value of t. Et is expected value of t, that small t. This is based on sample observations we find the value. So, that expected value of t is equal to the true theta, or expected value of t, that is et, minus true population parameter, that is true theta. Et minus theta is equal to 0. For example, the average monthly salary of Indian workers as per point estimate, 15,000 rupees. The true theta value is also 15,000. Our estimate value is also 15,000. So, there is no difference between actual value and our estimated value. Therefore, then there is no bias at all. So, ET, expected value of T minus true theta is equal to 0, then it is called the estimator as unbiased estimator. If this equality does not hold, then the estimator is said to be biased, and the bias is calculated as bias T is equal to expected T minus true theta. Now, we can see with the graph here true theta value, that is a normal distribution curve. We have taken the expected values on x axis and probability distributions on y axis. Say expected value we can measure with the ET, capital E and bracket small t. Theta is the true value or actual value, unknown population parameter we can say. The population parameter value is at theta, actual value is at theta. Our expected value is also on at that particular point theta only. Where theta is there, true theta is there, expected T is also there. Both lies on the same point. Then that is called unbiased estimator of true population parameter theta. Then biased estimator of theta we can examine. On x axis we take the actual true population value and expected sample value also we take on x axis, and on y axis that is probability distribution. Here true population value is left side, but our expected value ET, sample value, is right side. The gap between true population parameter theta and E, that is capital E in bracket small t, that gap is called bias. So, that means we can say the example in the earlier the true population parameter is 15,000. If with the sample data we got only a 10,000, that means the gap between 15,000 and 10,000, that is biased. So, that is biased estimator of theta. Second property is consistency. An estimator T, that is expected T, is said to be consistent estimator of theta if it approaches the true value theta as the sample size gets larger and larger. T tends to theta as n tends to infinite. That means you just observe the graph. In the first one, where the sample size is equal to 20, n is equal to 20, but theta is at center place, the true population value parameter is theta, and here the sample size is only 20. With this sample size, we will not estimate the true value theta. And the second one also, n is equal to 50. The sample size earlier it was 20, now it is 50. Even then also, we are not reaching the true value theta. Then, if you are not reaching the actual value theta, then we have to increase the sample size. If we increase the sample size, that is earlier it was 50, now we have been increased 100. That means if we go on increasing the sample size, then the sample estimate, that is expected T, will reach the true theta. So, that means if T tends to theta as n tends to infinite, that means if we go on increasing the sample size, then only we can estimate the true population parameter theta. Efficiency. If there are two unbiased estimators of a given parameter theta, there are two types of estimators, then The estimator with a smaller variance is considered to be more efficient than the other estimator. Suppose T1 and T2 are the two alternative estimators of parameter theta. Parameter theta means that is true population theta. Earlier, I took an example of salaries of workers in Indian Railways. If we collect the entire population or the actual value is say for example 15,000. Here to estimate that 15,000 there is T1 and T2, two methods. One you can take it as sample mean and another one is sample median. So T1 is the sample mean and T2 is the sample median. If the variance of T1 is smaller than the variance of T2, then estimator T1 is called minimum variance, unbiased, best unbiased or efficient estimator. We can say that if the estimator with minimum variance compared to the alternative estimator, here we have taken two examples T1 and T2. T1 is the sample mean, T2 is the sample median. So, with the sample mean the variance we got very less and with the sample median the variance we got is more. So, compared to this T1 and T2, T1 is minimum variance compared to T2 estimator. Therefore, T1 is called minimum variance, unbiased, best unbiased or efficient estimator, we can say. With graph we can say that where T1 shows that less variance and T2 has more variance. Sufficiency. An estimator is said to be sufficient if it conveys as much information as is possible about the parameter which is contained in the sample. A sufficient estimator ensures that all information a sample can furnish with respect to the estimation of a parameter is being utilized. That means, if sample provides all the information, that means if the estimator provides entire information, then it is called sufficient estimator. For example, if you want to find out the average figures, we can prefer either median or mean. To find out average figure, if you follow the mean, that is, we have to collect each and every observations in mean, whereas in median, we will not take all the observations. Only first we arrange the ascending order and middle value we can take. Based on that only we can estimate. So, therefore, compared to median, mean is a sufficient estimator because it is providing each and every observation's information. So, with this I can conclude that basic concepts of estimation.